Hello students, today I am going to discuss topic radical idea. I will discuss with you about two radicals, Nil Radical and Jacobson Radical. In this lecture, I will talk about Nil Radical of a ring. So let us start my lecture with the definition of radical idea. A two-sided ideal I in a ring R with one is called a radical ideal with respect to a specified property P. If I satisfies this property P and I is maximal among all two-sided ideals satisfying this property P. That is, if J is any other two-sided ideal of ring R having property P, then J is contained in I, maximal in this sense. So, let us recall the definition of nilpotent ideal. A right ideal I of ring IR is called nilpotent if some power of this ideal is zero for some positive integer n. And an ideal is called nil ideal if every element of I is nilpotent. So we can see easily that every nilpotent ideal is nil, but the converse need not be true. So suppose R is this ring, infinite sum of rings of this kind, Z modulo PI, I 1 2 is the direct sum of this. Then we consider I to be set of all nilpotent elements of R. It is easy to see that I is ideal of R. So we will show that I is nil ideal, but I is not nilpotent. Now, since I is the set of all nilpotent elements, so therefore every element of I is nilpotent. Therefore I is nil ideal. But suppose I raised to power k is 0 for some positive integer k, then this means every kth power of element of I should be 0. But if I consider this element 0 plus p, 0 plus p square, 0 plus pk, and then p plus pk plus 1, kth power of this will be 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, and here it will be pk plus pk plus 1, which is not 0. So therefore, there is an element x in I whose kth power is not 0. So therefore, ik is not 0. So thus, I is not nilpotent. So that means every nil ideal need not be nilpotent. Now we are ready to define nil radical. So, the nil radical of a ring R is defined to be radical ideal with respect to the property a two-sided ideal is nil. That is, an ideal I of ring R is called nil. Property is a two-sided ideal is nil. That means nil radical of a ring R will be a two-sided ideal, which is nil. And if there is any other two-sided nil ideal of ring R, then that will be contained in nil radical of ring R. We will denote nil radical of a ring R by NR. So we can say that NR is the largest two-sided nil ideal of R. The natural question which arises is whether for any ring R nil radical exists. So answer is yes. So before that, let us see some examples of nil radicals of a known rings. Let R be a ring which has no non-trivial nilpotent elements. Then clearly nil radical of R will be just the zero ideal. Suppose R is integral domain. Then we know that any integral domain has no non-trivial nilpotent elements. So nil radical of R will be zero. So from here I can say that nil radical of Z, Q, R, C, Z, P, where P prime is just the zero ideal. Now look at the ring Z mod 4Z. So it can be seen easily that nil radical of Z mod 4Z will be 2Z mod 4Z, because the ideals of Z mod 4Z are 0 ideal, 2Z mod 4Z, and Z mod 4Z. But there are elements in Z mod 4Z which are not nilpotent. So nil radical of Z mod 4Z will be 2Z mod 4Z. Now consider the ring MRD, the ring of matrices over division ring D. Now, since this ring has only two-sided ideals, only two-sided ideals, namely 0 and the ring itself. And we know that every element of MRD is not nilpotent. So therefore, nil radical of MRD will just be the 0 ideal. So now the question arises, whether nil radical of given ring exists? So answer is yes. For any ring R, nil radical exists. Moreover, it is given by this set. This will be the set of those elements A of R such that the two-sided ideal generated by A is nil ideal. That is, every element of two-sided ideal generated by A is nilpotent. Now recall that arbitrary element of two-sided ideal generated by A will look like this. NA plus left multiple of A plus right multiple of A plus UAV, where U is in R and V is in R. So let us try to prove that the nil radical of any ring is equal to this set. So for this, we need to show that the set on the right hand side is two-sided ideal and it is the largest two-sided ideal, satisfying the property of being a nil radical. Now, since 0 is two-sided nil ideal of R, therefore the set is non-empty set. Now, let A belongs to NR and X belongs to R. Now, clearly XA belongs to ideal generated by A, and since A belongs to NR, so two-sided ideal generated by A is nil. That means every element of this ideal is nilpotent. So in particular, XA is nilpotent. Okay. So this means two-sided ideal generated by XA is contained in two-sided ideal generated by A. Since every element of two-sided ideal A is nilpotent, so therefore every element of ideal generated by XA is also nilpotent. This means ideal generated by XA is nil two-sided ideal. Similarly, we can prove that AX belongs to NR. Now, let AB belongs to NR. So we want to show that A minus B belongs to NR. That means two-sided ideal generated by A minus B is nil ideal. Now, A minus B can be written like A plus minus B, which belongs to ideal generated by A plus ideal generated by B. This means ideal generated by A minus B is contained in ideal generated by A plus ideal generated by B. So thus, arbitrary element of this set can be written as Y plus Z, where Y belongs to ideal generated by A and Z belongs to ideal generated by B. Now, since A belongs to NR, so this ideal is nil. B belongs to NR, so this ideal is nil. So this means Y and Z are nilpotent. So let Y N is 0 and Z M is 0, and suppose that N is greater than equal to M. Then X N, let us consider Y plus Z N. Now, if we open this, we can see that it will be Y N plus some expression which will contain Z as its one of the terms. So where Z dash is sum of monomials in Y and Z, and in each term of Z dash, Z has a factor. So that means Z dash belongs to two-sided ideal generated by Z, which is contained in ideal generated by B. But B belongs to NR, so this is nil ideal. So therefore, Z dash is nilpotent. So thus we have Y plus Z N is equal to, now this is 0, this is equal to Z dash. And let Z dash S be 0. So Y plus Z N S will be 0. That means Y plus Z is nilpotent. But Y plus Z is equal to X, so we get that X is nilpotent. So therefore, we get that two-sided ideal generated by A minus B is nilpotent. This means A minus B belongs to NR. So thus, NR is two-sided ideal of R. Now, suppose J is any other two-sided nil ideal of R. So let A belongs to J. This means two-sided ideal generated by A is contained in J. This means two-sided ideal A is nil. So this means A belongs to NR. So therefore J is contained in NR. So thus this set NR is largest two-sided nil ideal of R. So this is nil radical. So hence we have shown the existence of nil radical of a ring R. Now, this is an easy corollary that for any ring R, nil radical of R modulo NR is just the zero ideal. Now see, we have seen that NR is two-sided ideal of R. So this makes sense. Now let us take an arbitrary element in this quotient ring. In the nil radical of this quotient ring. This means two-sided ideal generated by A bar is nil ideal of R mod NR. So this means every element of two-sided ideal A bar is nilpotent in R mod NR. So this means every element of two-sided ideal A is in NR. This means two-sided ideal A is nil ideal of R. This means A belongs to NR. So thus we get that A bar is 0 bar. So thus nil radical of R mod NR is just the 0 ideal. Now, this is a very interesting observation that if R is a commutative ring with 1, then nil radical takes this very nice shape that nil radical will just be the set of all nilpotent elements of R. Let us see. Suppose A belongs to NR. So this means two-sided ideal generated by A is nil ideal. This means every element of this ideal is nilpotent. Now, see, since R is a commutative ring with 1, so this implies A is nilpotent. So this means NR is contained in right-hand side. Now, conversely, suppose that A belongs to this set. This means A is nilpotent, and this means any multiple of A by element of ring will be nilpotent. Now see, if R is a commutative ring with 1, then elements of two-sided ideal generated by A will just be the multiples of A with elements of R. So this means two-sided ideal A is nil ideal. This means A belongs to NR. So thus, if R is commutative ring with 1, NR is nothing but the set of all nilpotent elements of R. Now with the help of this, we find the nilpotent elements of Rx, the ring of polynomials in one variable x with coefficients from R. Suppose R is a commutative ring with 1, then a polynomial a0 plus a1x plus anxn is nilpotent if and only if the coefficients a0, a1, an are nilpotent. So let us see. Suppose fx is equal to a0 plus a1x plus anxn is nilpotent. So this means some power of fx is 0. Let that power be n. Suppose fm is 0 for some m greater than or equal to n. So from here we get that anm is 0. That is, an is nilpotent. Now, an is nilpotent, so this means anxn is nilpotent. Because if anm is 0, then mth power of this expression will also be 0. Now, consider the polynomial fx minus anxn. Now, see, fx is nilpotent, anxn is nilpotent, and the set of all nilpotent elements of ring R is an ideal. So therefore, f minus anxn will be nilpotent. Now again applying the same procedure as here, we get that an minus 1 is nilpotent. So continuing like this, we will be able to show that a0, a1, an are nilpotent. Now suppose a0, a1, a2, an are nilpotent. Now see, if a1 is nilpotent, then a1x is nilpotent. If a2 is nilpotent, then a2x square is nilpotent. If an is nilpotent, then anxn is nilpotent. And since the set of nilpotent elements of ring R forms an ideal, so therefore some of these elements will be nilpotent and hence fx will be nilpotent. So thus we can say that nil radical of ring Rx, where R is a commutative ring with 1, is nothing but the polynomials of the type a0 plus a1x plus anxn, where a0 is nilpotent, a1 is nilpotent, a2 is nilpotent, and so on, an is nilpotent. So as a corollary to this theorem, we can see that nil radical of zx, the ring of polynomials in one variable x with coefficients from z, is nothing but the zero ideal. Similarly, nil radical of qx, rx, cx is nothing but the zero ideal. Thank you.